In a world where the past often whispers secrets to the present, an unexpected figure steps into the light, challenging the royal narratives we thought were sealed in history. Nick Lowcock, a man of quiet existence and retired from the racetrack roar, claimed a truth so bold it could rewrite chapters of England's grand story. In 2004, armed with a steadfast belief, he declared himself the rightful heir to a lineage hidden beneath the heavy cloaks of royal discretion. He was the great-grandson of Princess Louise, the rebellious jewel in Queen Victoria's dignified crown. The tale he spun was woven with threads of scandal and secrecy, challenging the image of an era led by a queen celebrated for her moral rigour. Nick's quest was not just personal, it questioned history's silence. His resolve led him to the courts, demanding a controversial act that echoed through the silent halls of tradition, the exhumation of his grandfather's remains to claim his place among Britain's noble legacies. Yet the guardians of the past held firm, and Nick's plea was met with refusal, leaving him stranded between the whispers of possibility and the stern silence of the establishment. But the narrative took an unexpected turn as he stood, thwarted by the very institution that might redefine his life. Lucinda Hawksley, a writer with a keen eye for the shadows cast by history's sunset, began peeling back the layers of a woman far beyond her time, Princess Louise herself. What truth would her biography unearth? And could the unveiling of one woman's life bring retribution to a man's quest for identity? The stage was set, the players ready, and history's pages seemed to rustle with anticipation, waiting for the next act in a drama spanning centuries. Lucinda Hawksley's journey into the depths of royal history began with optimism, but soon morphed into a labyrinth of dead ends and whispered secrets. As a seasoned investigator into the British royal family's intricate past, she approached the sacred archives at Windsor, expecting the usual protocol, but instead found herself facing an unprecedented barrier. The personal files of Princess Louise, a figure known for her beauty and rebellious spirit, were sealed away from public eyes. Undeterred, Hawksley extended her search to the Argyll archives in Scotland, home to Louise's husband's lineage, only to be met with firm denial once more. The mystery deepened as doors closed on her at every turn, even extending to the lives of those merely connected to Louise, from artists to attendants. Confusion reigned not just for Hawksley, but among the stewards of history themselves. Archivists from institutions far and wide, from the National Gallery to archives in Malta and Canada, expressed their bewilderment as they discovered that all relevant documents had been centralized in Windsor. This concerted effort to obscure Louise's story only fueled Hawksley's resolve. So what secrets did Louise's life hold, so potent that they warranted such an extensive concealment? Hawksley's quest for answers became a race against the shadows of history, determined to uncover the truth behind the silence. Meanwhile, the backdrop to this modern-day mystery was the stark contrast between Princess Louise's vibrant character and her mother's cold indifference. Queen Victoria, known for her strict demeanour and lack of maternal warmth, had distanced herself from her children. Louise, the overlooked child, grew under the weight of neglect, her vibrant spirit clashing with the rigid expectations of royal etiquette. This clash marked her as the family rebel, a label that haunts her throughout her life. At the heart of the enigma was a young Louise, captivating yet controversial, emerging into society's spotlight. The sudden and mysterious dismissal of her brother's tutor, Lieutenant Walter George Stirling, added layers to an already convoluted puzzle. Was there more to the release than the health concerns of a fragile prince? As shadows of doubt cast long across the royal narrative, Hawksley stood at the edge of a revelation that could shake the foundations of royal history. What was the true nature of Louise's relationship with the dashing lieutenant, and could it be the key to unlocking the secrets Windsor worked so hard to conceal? The sudden dismissal of Lieutenant Walter George Stirling from Queen Victoria's household sent ripples through the royal corridors. igniting whispers and speculation that refused to be silenced. Despite his recognised integrity and commendable qualities, his proposed reassignment to train Prince Arthur was flatly rejected by the Queen. This decision only fueled the fires of rumours, suggesting that the reasons behind his departure were deeply personal and potentially scandalous. The royal household was abuzz, but the whispers of Louise's possible pregnancy eventually took centre stage. Given the era's fashion, which skillfully concealed the body contours, the princess's condition could easily remain unnoticed by the public eye. The styles of the day, with their elaborate frills, pleats and decorations, were perfectly designed to mask the physical signs of pregnancy. Yet these fashion anomalies, the sudden shift in Louise's attire to more embellished and concealing garments, raised eyebrows. The enigma deepened with Queen Victoria's observations. The absence of servants to assist Louise with dressing, an unusual practice for a royal of her stature, hinted at a desperate attempt to keep a secret hidden from even the closest circle members. The personal turmoil Louise experienced during this period adds layers to the mystery. Her words, filled with sorrow and hints of deep-seated conflict, suggest a woman caught amid a crisis, trapped by the expectations of her royal duty and the reality of her situation. The noticeable decrease in her public engagements, particularly her reluctance to leave her carriage during rare appearances, further corroborates the swirling rumours of her condition. As the puzzle pieces align, the story unfolds as one of royal secrecy, personal struggle, and the lengths the royal family might go to protect his reputation. But what truth lay buried beneath these carefully constructed appearances? And how would the revelation of such secrets change the perception of a princess known for her beauty and spirit, but possibly remembered for a scandal carefully veiled by the fabric of her gowns? The mystery of Princess Louise's life continues to challenge the boundaries between public duty and personal truth. If Princess Louise's secretive sorrow was indeed a concealed pregnancy, the timeline suggests that the child would have been born in the depths of winter, a secret whispered away by the chill winds of the royal palace. By February, Louise re-emerged in public view, her figure restored, encapsulated in white satin for the opening of Parliament, an event meticulously documented, yet silent on the whispers of months past. The intrigue deepened with the birth of her niece, Louise, in a surprising deviation from royal tradition. This unexpected choice by her brother Bertie and his wife Alex, future king and queen, sparked speculation. Was this an act of family solace, a subtle nod of acknowledgement to Louise's hidden ordeal, a shared secret silently saluting her loss and love? The mystery was further compounded by the words of another brother, Prince Arthur, whose veiled references to an unspeakable great secret in his correspondence with Louise hinted at an inner circle of knowledge and complicity, a bond sealed by unspoken truths. Amidst these undercurrents of silence and secrecy, Queen Victoria's actions towards Walter Stirling painted a portrait of fear and contradiction. Despite public accolades and his seamless return to military life, her private correspondences revealed a monarch shadowed by dread, not of scandal alone, but of Stirling's potential to unravel the tightly wound threads of royal discretion. The paradox of Victoria's response awarding Stirling a title and an annuity in exchange for his absence and silence unveils the complexities of royal benevolence, the high price of the monarchy's tranquility. What necessitated such a grave pact between a queen and her officer, and how did these decisions sculpt the hidden contours of royal history? The layers of secrecy, the unspoken truths, and the whispers of the past converge into a narrative shrouded in mystery. As the puzzle pieces linger unanswered, the silent agreement between a queen and her subject is a testament to the lens the crown would go to protect its legacy. What truths remain veiled by the royal tapestry, and how would the revelations of these buried secrets challenge the very foundations of Britain's storied monarchy? Princess Louise bore a child out of wedlock, the implications for the royal family would have been staggering. The Victorian era, marked by stringent social norms and the sanctity of the royal image, would have rendered it impossible for a princess to keep an illegitimate child. Enter the figure of Sir Charles Lowcock, Queen Victoria's trusted accoucheur, a man positioned perfectly within the royal circle to handle such a delicate matter with the utmost discretion. The narrative takes a curious turn with the sudden residential change of Frederick Lowcock, Sir Charles's son, to a location strikingly close to royal grounds, coupled with a series of events that defy conventional Victorian behaviours, a rapid remarriage after his mother's death, and an equally rapid adoption of a baby boy. These anomalies, set against the backdrop of Victorian decorum, suggest a covert operation, possibly orchestrated at the highest levels of royalty to secure the future of an innocent born into scandal, yet ignorant of its cause. The involvement of Lady Stirling, adding a family link to the alleged father, Lieutenant Walter Stirling, further thickens the plot, suggesting a network of silence and support to shield the child and the monarchy from potential disgrace. The adoption of baby Henry under such mysterious and financially supported circumstances, along with the considerable legacy left by Frederick Lowcock, implies a concealed truth, a secret lie threaded into the fabric of the Lowcock family history, sustained by whispers of royal lineage and veiled visits by a princess to a child she could never publicly acknowledge. Nick Lowcock's quest for truth and recognition in the courts may appear on the surface to be a solitary battle against the annals of history, but beneath it lies a tapestry of family lore, whispered secrets, and the enduring love of a mother forced by circumstance to distance herself from her child. The story that passed down through generations suggests a clandestine bond marked by discreet visits and silent acknowledgements, a connection that transcended the barriers imposed by royal duty and societal expectations. The narrative beckons us to question, how deep do the roots of secrecy go within the walls of royal heritage, and what personal sacrifices are made to protect a lineage? The mystery of Princess Louise and the child possibly left behind is a poignant reflection of the hidden human stories within the grandeur of royal history. In the whispers of history and the murmurs of the Lowcock family, the legacy of Henry, believed by his descendants to be the hidden offspring of Princess Louise, unfolds with subtle intrigue. If Henry were merely a man caught in the webs of his imagination, one would expect his adoptive father, Frederick, to refute the lofty claims. Yet Frederick remained silent, a silence that carried the weight of unspoken truths. Within the walls of the Lowcock household rest items of royal origin, tokens of a past intertwined with Britain's grand narrative. Among those, a bronze sculpture of a baby, a gift from Queen Victoria, holds the silent whispers of a royal secret, perhaps crafted by Louise herself. Additionally, a uniquely adorned photograph of infant Henry hints at the artistic touch of his supposed royal mother, suggesting connections not just of blood, but of heart and craft. As the chapters of Henry's life unfolded, from his quiet upbringing to his untimely death in Canada under mysterious circumstances, the narrative threads a weave of complex tapestry. Was his journey across the Atlantic a mere land venture, or was it a quest to connect with Walter Stirling, the man speculated to be his biological father? Enigmatically establishing a trust fund for Henry's children after his death adds layers of speculation to the family's royalties. Meanwhile, Louisa's life story, marred by a forced union and secret romances, paints a portrait of a woman trapped by circumstance and royal duty. The sealed lips of the past and the locked archives guard Louisa's life's truths fiercely. While Lucinda Hawksley's quest for answers has peeled back the veiled corners of history, the full extent of Louisa's story remains just beyond reach. So the story concludes not with a definitive answer, but with a lingering question left in your hands. What do you believe lies hidden in the silent chapters of Princess Louisa's life?